Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and if the settings are a little bit strange in this video, it's because I have tried to make them better. I don't know if I succeeded, so maybe in a couple of videos it will look a little bit strange. But today I am doing another duping video, and I am duping the Melt She's Impartis. And I have two options. One that I'm going to show you that is not that similar, but a little similar. And then one where I have picked together some single shades. So I thought I could start with the thing that is just a little bit similar. And I actually think that the Dreamy palette from Nabla, this was their first palette, it has some shades that the She's Impartis have, like this one, and a little bit more of the purple and a lighter pink. So if you have this, I think you can take this and like take other single shadows, because what this misses is like a deep dark shade, I think. But other than that, overall I think this is kind of good actually. But the shades I'm going to play with today is these seven single shades. I've taken out these two as well. These are no longer available, but if you have these two at home, you can use them instead. And that is Prom Night and Cherry Cola, both from Makeup Geek, but I'm going to talk about these seven singles. And as you can see, two are from Makeup Geek. It's the small one, so this one and this one. Then these two are from Nabla, and the three that is left is from Lethal. And I am going to swatch this for you, so you'll see. And this was actually so hard to make this like a good dupe. I have been swatching for maybe half an hour. So here are the swatches, and I don't think you can see the first shade that is here. That is Vanilla Bean from Makeup Geek. Then we have Ground State from Nabla, Artemisia from Nabla as well. Then it is one from Lethal, that is Trespass. And a shimmery one. This was so hard to like pick a good shade. That is also from Lethal, and that is Defense, I think it's called or pronounced like that. Then we have one from Makeup Geek that is Vintage, and the last one is Rebirth from Lethal as well. So I'm going to do a makeup look with this, and I actually don't know what I want to do. The She's Impartis palette I have never been like interested in, so I have not thought out a look that I want to do. As with the 420 palette and Millennial Pinks, I really wanted those palettes. But this She's Impartis, I don't think I wanted. So I don't know if I'm 100% happy with the color story I picked out. But the difference from this She's Impartis than the 420 and Millennial Pinks, I have not been that interested in this palette because it's not my like typical colors. But you really wanted me to try to dupe this, and I tried my best. So I'm going to stare on these swatches a bit to see what I want to do. I am not going to use this Vanilla Bean, I think, because yeah. But do you see? I have almost hit pen in this. But yeah, okay, I will stare at this for a little while, and then I'm going to start with makeup. I will start with Artemisia, this one from Nabla, and take it in my crease. And I also thought it was so hard to find good swatches on this palette. I have noticed this, or I have seen it a lot with Melt swatches and also other brands. The swatches are not that true to like reality, so it's kind of hard to try to get like the correct swatches. So I will leave the blog post, I think it was, where I took the swatches and also the picture that I put in this video. I took it from a blog. I did it with the 420 palette as well, because I feel that Melt's own swatches are, I don't know, they look really impressive, but it's not reality. Okay, and then I actually think I will go in with Vintage, this one, just to deepen down my crease a bit, and I think this brush is maybe too big. But I am doing this. This brush was too big. Like, I can't stop now. So I think I just want to go in with the Artemisia a little bit more, and now Astrid is doing something in the kitchen. Feels like I want to try to do this look pretty dark, because I really like that about the She's in Paradise palette, that it is kind of dark. So I will try to go in with Trespass, I think this is. Yes. And take it on my outer half. Maybe not outer half, but take it out here. And one shade I thought was so hard to try to find a dupe in. But it's, I guess it's pretty easy, but in these duping palettes, I either want to take like a whole palette and maybe add some singles, but I don't want to take a shade, take in a palette just for one shade, because I think the She's in Paradise has like one darker shimmery brown or like a plummy shade, and I think I have something like that in one of my Juvia's Place palettes. But I don't want to take like one shade from 16 pan palette, so I didn't take it, so I tried to do it like this instead. Okay, now I want to go in with Ground State from Nabla. This one, I have had this shadow for such a long time. I think I've used it maybe twice. And then when I started to swatch it today, I was like, why haven't I used this before? And this was not a shade that I bought myself. I got it in like a subscription box, and okay, maybe I should have cut my crease for this actually. It feels like it was a really, really long time ago since I cut my crease, so I will do it today. And I take NYX Glare Primer and a small little brush and just tap it, and I'm going to... Okay, and now we will see if this looks better. I really, really hope it should do. If it don't, I am going to be a little bit worried about this shade, and that's maybe why I only used it twice. Oh, this is much better. Maybe this wasn't like the best combo I have ever seen, but okay. I'm going in with the shade from Lethal just to blend this a little bit better together. When you don't have enough hands, use your mouth. Okay, was this dirty? I don't know.
This is usually how I sit.
Okay, I don't know why. Did I miss to put on glitter primer here? Kinda like this. I'm not 100% sure, but I think I do, and I have a lot of fallouts. And I also think I want to go in with Artemisia the lightest shade I used in my crease first from Nabla and just take it down here. Because I didn't know that I was going to cut my crease. I can do it on this eye. No. Okay, so I'm going to cut a half cut crease on this eye as well, fix my base, and then I come back and we do the under eyes together. I don't think you need to see me being super concentrated and cut this crease. So I'll fix that off cam, fix my base, and then I come back. Okay, so it's time for the under eyes. And about my base, I tested a new foundation I have on this Bear With Me from NYX. It's a tinted skin veil in pale light. And then also new settings on the camera. I don't know if that was a good idea. But time for the under eyes at least. And I think... How do I look? I think I'll take this Vintage from Makeup Geek and just swirl it. Not swirl it, but take it on my eyes. And this is pretty dark, so I hope it doesn't look too off. So I'm going to take Vanilla Bean that I said I'm not going to use and take it in my inner corner. This is a matte shade, but it has some sparkles in it. So I'm going to take it in my inner corner, maybe a little bit on ground state. The shimmer, and we will see how this goes. So I will tap it off and I have no idea. This is either going to make it like all blurry. I don't know how much this is showing, if you can see it or not. Maybe it was super unnecessary, but now it's done. So I'm going to put something in my waterline, put on mascara and take a lippy, and then I come back. So this is the finished look. For my waterline, I took Cry Baby from ColourPop, and on my lips I took a new one from Lethal that is called Pandemonium, it should be. It's a purple. If you've been here, purple is not my favorite to have on my lips, but I was like, okay, I have a kind of purple eye look, so I wanted to take a purple lip shade. So this is my She's Imparted look, and these were the colors that I have picked. I used Vanilla Bean from Makeup Geek and also Vintage from Makeup Geek. And then I used Ground State. I can never remember. I think they have a Garden State or something like that in the Soul Blooming. I can never remember the name. I think it's Ground State. I used that and Artemisia also from Nabla. And then I used Trespass. Yeah, and that was actually all the shades I used. So I kind of like this look, actually. I don't know if this one was the best thing to take in my crease, but I like the look. I really like this one. It needed, though, a glitter primer underneath, but now it looks really good. I think the lips are a little bit too purple for this look. Maybe I should have gotten in with something else, but now I have it on, so I'm going to have this with these purple lips. And it looks in the viewfinder that the lighting is, or I have problem with white balance. For you that doesn't film or anything, I don't know if you don't know what I'm talking about, but I have a problem with white balance. I usually have it on auto. It feels though this video has been really, really yellow. It looks really yellow in the viewfinder, but it's not always the same in the viewfinder that it is when I take it into the computer and edit it. If this looks shit, I'm going to try something else with the settings. I have to check it. But I really hope you liked this. It was kind of fun to dupe this palette, even though this has not been a palette that I really wanted. Now I think I'm going to end this duping melt palettes. And I'm actually going to try to dupe some of my limited edition palettes that I did a video on. I can leave it up here. I talked about 6 eyeshadow palettes and 2 highlight palettes. I'm pretty sure. I may want to try to dupe some of them, because it was more than one of you that wanted me to do that, so I'm going to try. I don't know if I will do looks with all the palettes or not, because it is going to be 6 videos and it's going to take kind of long time, so maybe I dupe some of them and do a makeup look, and the rest I will just have a talky video with the palettes I've duped. Okay, that is all. I am going to eat something now, so I'm going to end this video here. I really hope you liked this, and I did a little bit of counting to see what is going to be cheaper to buy, these single shadows or the palette. When I made it to Swedish crowns, this was like 150 crowns cheaper, so maybe around $12 cheaper. I don't know if it's worth it, but I think you can dupe the most of your palettes. If you have a bigger collection, I think you can dupe the most of them. So this was my little She's in Pardis palette. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!